And members of the liberal press are doing everything in their power to portray Minnesota Congresswoman as a dummy in the wake of her presidential announcement. I'm not sure where their video cameras and pointed questions were back when the anointed one misspoke and fumbled and embarrassed himself. Let's take a look at some of the greatest hits.
Iran, Cuba, Venezuela, these countries are tiny compared to the Soviet Union. You send a kid to the emergency room for a treatable illness like asthma. They end up taking up a hospital bed. It costs, when if you they just gave you gave them treatment early, and they got some treatment and a breathalyzer or an inhalator.
On this Memorial Day, as our nation honors its unbroken line of fallen heroes, and I see many of them in the audience here today. I've now been in 57 states.
I don't know what the term is in Austrian, wheeling and dealing. Navy Corpsman Christian Bouchard. Corpsman Bouchard. Corpsman Bouchard.
Corpsman. The president's sidekick, Jumpin' Joe Biden, has also been known to let a gaffe or two slip. Take a look.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent. It's a fully, I'm not joking.
Chuck Graham, state senator's here. Chuck, stand up, Chuck. Let him see you. Oh, God love you. What am I talking about?
If we do everything right, we do it with absolute certainty, we stand up there and we make really tough decisions, there's still a 30% chance we're going to get it wrong.
By the way, do you know the website?
You know, I'm embarrassed. You know the website number? I should have it in front of me, and I don't. It is recovery.gov.
All right. Somehow, though, the media has let those astonishing screw-ups slide. And joining me now with reaction to the media double standard on display this week and always is Democratic strategist Mo Alethi is with us, a nationally syndicated radio talk show host, Hugh Hewitt. Guys, welcome back.
Good to be back, Sean.
You know,
thanks, Sean.
It's funny in the wake of the criticism, Hugh, against Michelle Bachmann, that all those other things got pushed away. They didn't really become the big, you know, oh my goodness, this, look how stupid, 57 states, Navy corpsmen. Why? Why is there the double standard?
And Sean, you had to truncate that. You didn't use Comiskey Field on Joe Biden. You didn't do the three-letter word jobs.
Wait a minute. I mean, I got
there's
that
an
one.
Endless array of this.
I got
Here,
Joe
here's
Biden
what's
jobs.
Going on.
I'm going to run it. You asked for it. We got the greatest hits.
It is the perfect one.
Look, John's last-minute economic plan does nothing to tackle the number one job facing the middle class, and it happens to be, as Barack says, a three-letter word, jobs, J-O-B-S, jobs.
How do you spell potato?
And Sean, I'll tell you, this is just the media attempting to divert attention. When they go after Michelle Bachmann, who's very smart, has her LLM in taxation from William & Mary Law School. I've been on many stages with her. She's very, very sharp. But when they go after her, it's a diversion because they're so invested in President Obama and his image as being a really smart guy and sophisticated. That's fallen apart. The American people are beginning to realize President Obama is not that sharp. His policies have failed. The presidency is in collapse. And Joe Biden is a clear and present danger to common sense everywhere. So they have to divert from this failure of a presidency and attack Michelle Bachmann or other Republicans. And it's not going to get any better because the Manhattan Beltway media elite are invested in Barack Obama.
You know, but Mo, there's those gaffes by the president and by Joe Biden, they're pretty severe. I mean, because you know and I know, and I said this in the last segment, you know, he was reading a teleprompter. He didn't know what the word corpsman is. If he messed up once and then corrected himself, fine. But then he said it again and again. And that's a little frightening. And I just would imagine, you know, the left-wing media in this country, and if George W. Bush had made such a mistake.